welcome back to Scale Me Down. Please like and subscribe to support our channel, and please press the bell icon to get notifications when we post a new video. Now, this is a special edition all about scale model helicopters, and we're going to have a look at some of the scale machines that I've built over the years before we go out to the field and see them fly. And scale machines have the ability to turn heads as much as the regular 3D aerobatic machines you see at your local club, but they offer a much more relaxed flying experience. This is my Eurocopter EC665 Tigre attack helicopter, and it's based on TRex 600 mechanics, running on 10 lithium cells. It was built from the RC Aerodyne kit, now Roban, and I've added lots of scale details and features that are not included with the kit.
So behind this door we have the Align voltage regulator, which powers the radio gear, and we also have an MKTEC isolator for the 10 cell system. So when it's connected and we release this magnetic plunger, it's then live, and it's all hidden away behind the scale door like this.
The pilots are the first I ever 3D printed, and represents Zenyan Orimov from the 1995 James Bond GoldenEye film, in which the Eurocopter Tiger features, although the aircraft is painted in a scale paint scheme from a demonstrator aircraft from the Paris Air Show. The weapons on the port wing here represent a pair of Stinger air-to-air missiles and some tow wire-guided anti-tank weapons, although they're all installed on neodymium magnets, so we can easily replace them like this. We'll replace those with the laser-guided Hellfire weapons. And on this side we have a Maverick bunker-busting weapon. This one's 3D printed, and again on magnets, we can replace that with this rocket pod.
The tail rotor arrangement on this machine is rather unusual, in that it used to be driven by a torque tube and a series of gears, but due to a couple of failures, I've replaced it with a direct drive brushless motor from a drone. This runs on a governor and a servo controlled to tail rotor pitch in the normal manner. Despite its weight, this model flies with great authority, and I have actually looped and rolled this model just like the full size does, although it's no 3D machine. The object above the rotors on the full-size machine is a mast-mounted sight, which is a device with a group of sensors for targeting the weapons whilst the helicopter is hiding behind trees and things. This is made possible on the model because the T-Rex 600 mechanics inside have a hollow main shaft. My friend Mark helped me with this design by machining some parts on his lathe.
Next up we have this Augusta A109 that I built from the Century UK fuselage kit, and it contains TRex 500 flybarless mechanics that I have stretched to TRex 550 size, as this is a 30 size fuselage. And it's in the colours of Northampton Air Ambulance, who were super helpful sending me the exact paint codes to get the finish, the colours just right. I also modified the kit to include scale sequenced nose gear doors, these scale air intakes, and also sprung audio retracting landing gear.
This machine is fitted with non-symmetrical spin blades from Germany, and that allows more lift at lower head speed, and in fact this machine runs at 1800 RPM, which is very low for a helicopter of this size. I still have some work to do yet, tuning the flybarless controller and also the landing gear sequencer, which is really lovely to fly. I love scale conversions from electric mechanics like this one, as there's no exhaust plume to spoil the scale effect and they sound just right. Agree that the landing gear I made looks far better than the retracts that come with the Century kit.
And finally, we have this little T-Rex 450 Pro inside a Bell Jet Ranger 206B fuselage.
This fuselage was moulded by a chap I met on the Scale RC Helis forum by the name of FACU. It's made from lightweight woven epoxy fiberglass and is dead scale. I made the landing gear myself from aluminium tubing. This machine rotates anti-clockwise, just like the full size, and that means that the tail rotor is on the correct side, on the left. in the hover, this means it hangs to the left, which looks a little unusual. Thanks for watching, and until next time, safe flying and soft landing.